Was it filled with TiO2? The speaker is Alok Sadabali. Okay.
Good morning, everybody. Dr. Maida, chair of this session, and my dear friends. I am Professor Alok Satpathy from National Institute of Technology. It's a premier technical institute located in the eastern part of India, and I come from mechanical engineering department. The previous speaker was my student. He has stolen most of my slides, so many slides are common. So I'll quickly go through the unstolen slides. My topic is thermal characteristics of polypropylene composite filled with titanium oxide. Composite is a material where dissimilar elements are mixed up to get a new material of superior qualities. So composite material is very much like the composition of the audience here. People from information technology, people from business administration, people from mechanical, industrial engineering, and people from various countries sitting together. That's like this. The contents of my talk will be, I'll be introducing you the topic, then define a composite, objective of this work, the details, results, and then the conclusions. As I told, definition of the composite, it's a multi-phase material. Phase, when I say phase, I say dissimilar materials combining together, and one or more discontinuous phases therefore are embedded in a continuous phase to form a composite material. One is usually harder, called the filler material, the other one is soft, called the matrix material. And then you get the newer material with superior qualities. The beauty of composite material is that in arithmetic, if you add 1 and 1, how much you get? 2. 1 plus 1 is 2. In love and romance, 1 plus 1 is always 1. But in composite, 1 plus 1 is 11. So all the superior properties you get in one material. Now, when you classify the composite, you have polymer matrix composite, metal matrix composite, and ceramic matrix composite. Our work is confined on polymer matrix composite. And the polypropylene that was there in the title is a polymer. It's a thermoplastic polymer to be specific. Now, you bring a polymer and put some material, just like we use sugar in tea, just like that. But sugar gets dissolved in the milk. Here, they are insoluble. The hard material remains hard throughout the matrix body. And why do we add them? To improve the mechanical properties, to improve the thermal properties, sometimes optical, electrical properties, tribological properties, and very often to reduce the cost and weight of the component. Now here we are in this work, we are adding a thermally conductive material like titanium oxide in a thermally insulative material like polypropylene, in order to improve its thermal conductivity so that the polypropylene matrix composite can be used in electronic encapsulations. That's the purpose. So there are two ways of doing that. Either you change the molecular orientation of the polymer, try to make it more conductive thermally, or you add conductive fillers into it. Both the way you can do it. But the first one is a more of a activity of a chemist. So we go for the other one. Addition of conductive fillers into non-conductive polymers. So a few experimental procedures I'll tell. This is the polypropylene, the matrix material. Okay, granules form, and then its conductivity is very low, 0.11, and the density is also less than 1 gram per cc. It has very good mechanical performance, cost effective, and it has high resistance to chemicals. That is about the polymer material. Now, the filler material, what I am adding into it is titanium, and it has got thermal conductivity 100 times higher than that of the polypropylene, 11.7, while the previous one was 0.11. So, I am adding titanium oxide onto this and getting composites like this. Okay, disc-shaped composite we make so that we measure the thermal conductivity. Now there are procedures, there are injection molding route, there is compression molding route, there is hand layup to route, but because this is a thermoplastic polymer material, normally we go for compression molding route. This is a picture of the compressor molding machine that is there in our laboratory, and then we make this composite. After making it, we measure the thermal conductivity by this uniform TM2022 model. This is the instrument to measure thermal conductivity based on this one dimensional heat flow. The other walls are adiabatic. So by using Fourier equation, we get the thermal conductivity. Now, even without conducting experiment, by using the empirical relations that are there derived by previous investigators, that there are a host of equations, and you can pick up any one suitable for your material and use them for finding out the conductivity of the material without even conducting the experiment. So we have done both the things. We have developed a empirical model, then calculated the thermal conductivity of the composite material, and then experimented it, then compared. And for deriving the mathematical model, we have taken a simple cubical model. This is a cube in which, this is a cube of polypropylene in which you have titanium particles filled in. So there is a lot of mathematics involving integration and all. I'm not going through all of them, but then the final expression is somewhat like this. In the final expression, the effective thermal conductivity or the composite thermal conductivity is very much a function of how much material you are putting into it, TiO2. So it's a function of the conductivity of the matrix material, conductivity of the filler material, and the conductivity of and the volume fraction of the filler material, how much volume we put in. Then after doing this, we got these results. We even used the other models proposed by the previous researchers and our model, which I just now showed, and then these are all theoretical models, and all the theoretical models give us the theoretical results. Then we experimented it using that the uniform 2022 model, and then we have compared this table actually presents the comparison, but this is more clear over here. And you can see that the proposed model is this one, the proposed model, and the other models are showing different results, but ours is matching with the experimental model very close, up to a clear fraction of 15%. After 15%, what happens? There will be a sudden jump in the thermal conductivity, as often found in case of polymer matrix composites. And that particular filler concentration is the threshold, that we call the percolation threshold, and beyond that, there is drastic increase in the conductivity. And so if you want more conductivity, go beyond 15. If you want less, you remain within 15. That's the beauty. Now, another important thermal characteristics about any composite is its glass transition temperature. Glass transition temperature gives you a functional limit. Within that temperature, you can the component will work well. So the advantage of adding TiO2 gives us an improvement in the glass transition temperature. So while with only polypropylene, you can only work within minus 15 degrees centigrade, now it's increasing to about 7 or 8 degrees centigrade. So that's the advantage, that's a bonus advantage if you add titanium oxide to polypropylene. He was doing what coefficient of thermal expansion. When there is temperature fluctuation, you don't want the material to expand. It will lead to mechanical failure and other problems. But adding titanium reduces the coefficient of thermal expansion, thereby even sorts out this problem. So these are again another additional advantages. So there are many good things about adding titanium into polypropylene. Many properties are improved, modified, and then based on the experimental results, we have concluded that the values of thermal conductivity, we call it effective thermal conductivity, opted for composite using our proposed theoretical model, they are in reasonable agreement with the experimental values, but only within the percolation limit, that's 15%. Now, addition of 25 volume percent of titanium oxide, you get an enhancement of 266% in thermal conductivity. That's the main finding of our work. Then the effective thermal conductivity of the composite increases, as I told. As you increase the titanium content, and rate of increase of this thermal conductivity is very rapid, that is sudden rise in the thermal conductivity beyond the percolation threshold. And moreover, with incorporation of TiO2, the glass transition temperature of the composite increases,
the coefficient of thermal expansion as desired decreases, and both are good results, and it makes the composite more suitable material for electronic packaging and encapsulation. These are the references, and thank you for your patience hearing.
Thank you very much, Professor. And do you have any questions or comments? Okay. All right. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.